Alrighty, on the draw round three with pretty strong hand here. I've got Library and Brainstorm, Mental Misstep, and Time Walk. These are all good cards to have in your opening hand. Library on the draw is kind of nice too. Ooh, this could get messy. Turn one, Monastery Mentor would be tough. I will admit that. Right. Probably just passing after playing Library, unless I drew something like a Mox. Probably just a Mox Sapphire is like the only one that I would even really want to play. Even then. Nothing on turn two? Well, that's not good news against the Library of Alexandria. Library does tend to do a pretty good job at punishing that. Ooh, I even drew the Mox so I didn't have to discard. Alright, things are turning up well. I could actually use Time Walk here. Yeah, actually, I kind of like that. I think a big incentive to use Time Walk is that I don't have any pitch counters or anything like that. So even if this gets countered, it's not like I was doing much with... I wasn't putting up much disruption. Yeah, Flusterstorm is fine. That's the only counter my opponent could have that's also good value, by the way. But it's got all of it. Propaganda is not a terrible draw because now, even if my opponent does play a creature, I could... slow down the beats. Probably gonna have to sack that Lotus for something. Well, or not. Mox Sapphire means presumably my opponent can make a play here. Otherwise, I'm not sure exactly what kind of hand they kept. It could be a hand with just a bunch of counters, which of course Library does do a very good job of destroying. Which, seems not too unreasonable to assume that at this point. Ooh, Force of Will is a good draw. And you have Library going, Force of Will is pretty high on the list of things you're looking for. So I'm choosing not to do anything because I think there's a good chance my opponent's got, you know, mana drain and whatnot in hand. So no real reason to get hasty. I will probably cast Thirst for Knowledge at the end of turn. I will also not update my computer. That was quite unexpected. Well, not that unexpected actually, but annoying nonetheless. So sacking to play Young Pyromancer. Okay. Between Propaganda and True New Nemesis, I'm not super worried about Young Pyromancer. I also don't want to get in a counter war with my opponent having red floating. I'd much rather do that later, when the red has left the pool. Time to library it up. And then cast Thirst for Knowledge, unless I drew... I drew like a repeal or something. I would have rather done that. It's a good chance I'll have to discard two to this Thirst as well. Assuming it resolves. Alright, Thirst didn't need resolve. I'm discarding a land and potentially a Mental Misstep, I think. Yeah, I want to keep everything else. Let's draw up to 9. Ooh, Strip Mine. Strip Mine is filthy. Alright, yeah, let's play Strip Mine. Let's destroy Tundra. This turns off Mana Drain. Not that Mentor Delver type decks play a ton of Mana Drains, but it also just makes my opponent's life more difficult when it comes to cards like Gush and whatnot. And I think I just play True Name. Could play Propaganda. Well, it's actually kind of interesting. Because if I play True Name, I can't back it up with Flusterstorm. I think I'll just play Propaganda. Because I would rather fight over this with Flusterstorm if my opponent does have a Force of Will. I'm making it pretty obvious, too. I'm tapping Library of Alexandria, leaving Island up. I also don't mind if I go below Library range. I've got Dig Through Time and Brainstorm, so I've got some card availability here. Alright. Flusterstorm, the Force of Will. See if my opponent has another Force of Will. Propaganda's gonna be pretty tough for my opponent to beat here. And you get a token, and you get a Propaganda. Alright. Let's pass. Propaganda, True Nemesis, the lock. opponent's just going to pass the turn back and do nothing. I guess if they draw land, they can hit me with Young Pyromancer, but... suppose they could also have Pyroblast in hand pretty easily, which I would mental misstep. Suppose if my opponent has a second mental misstep, because they pitch on a Force of Will, if they have a second mental misstep, oh man, I can just use Force of Will if I need to. Don't really want to, but it is definitely an option. Now you have mental misstep. Yeah, I should force this. Pitching Brainstorm. Don't love doing that, but I could easily get overwhelmed if I didn't have this Propaganda in play. Alright, let's play True Name Nemesis. Select my opponent, and I think I do play a land here. Even though I have Library in play, I believe that I'm building towards... I'm just going to cast Dig and be able to... I want to be able to cast like Jace next turn, or if I cast Gush... having played, well, I guess Gush gets me close enough to the library that I would rather do that, but. Alright, my opponent is going to get to cast Dig through time here. I got fairly punished for not leaving a second mental misstep in hand. Okay, so my opponent has one card in hand and is digging up to three or digging up to... I think digging up to three, but I'm not 100% sure. Yeah, it has to be three, because I want to just drew and cast this. So, I'm then going to get to cast Dig through time, presumably find something interesting. Guess my opponent could have found Force of Will blue card, but doesn't seem super likely. Well, it looks like they found Pyroblast. Or maybe Preordain. Or maybe Ancestral. Some looks like Pyroblast. Oh, or even Gush. Alright. Could be some combination of all of the above. Well, getting to the point where I might lose this game, even though I was fairly far ahead before. Well, they don't have a great attack this turn, but next turn... I mean, they can sack a token to deal two this turn. Next turn is going to be a lot bigger, so I need to find another... Propaganda here. Remora would have been nice to have, him play this turn. I will admit that. So next turn I block, take five. Yeah. Repeal is not horrible either. Opponent at this point has two lands and some other nonsense in hand. Alright, let's cast Dig. I need to find something decent here. Alright, I like Ancestral, I like Jace. I'll take those cards. Do I want to play Jace first? Jace does die, so let's Ancestral first. I don't think I want to cast back to basics this instant. let's just pass the turn. Propaganda is the one I'm looking for, not back to basics. And Repeal is not a horrible card either. So now, if I block a token, I take 5, go into 11. It just leave me a ton of turns here, so I can't imagine that the Pyromancer's attacking. Not yet, at least. Later, that might be the case, but... Not right now. Yeah, I am likely to lose this game, even though, again, I was very far ahead, but Pyromancer plus the second Pyroblast did the trick, and my opponent had a misstep to force me to fight, to use Force of Will here. And I had to exile Brainstorm. Well, I can't beat too many more spells. I might not be able to beat what I have, what my opponent has out right now. Tapping the library so I can leave mana drain up. Draw three cards. If I draw like Propaganda, Force of Will, or something like that, that could be sick. I do have like two turns here, and I might have slightly more if my opponent ends up not being able to play much more and has to send a bunch of tokens into Jace here. But we'll see. I guess the biggest decision now is, does my opponent have a lightning bolt, or are they considering bolting in response? Puts me to 8. That doesn't change the clock much. It kills Jace, but Jace can die anyway, so not super worried about that. Alright. Let's brainstorm with Jace. These are all cards that would have been a little better had I been in a position to play them before all this nonsense my opponent played, but that's okay. Alright, so I've got one draw step to draw Propaganda. I guess Repeal may buy me another turn here. Misdirection is interesting if my opponent casts a bolt or something. No real reason to cast Back to Basics at this point. Alright, so I take 5, going to 6 here, and then I go to 5 off of sacking the Scalding Tarn because I need to draw something. Hopefully this is something that triggers Remora. That gives me way more of a shot. So at this point I'm getting one draw step for Propaganda. Getting a second one off Remora could be huge. Yeah, my opponent really should not be casting Preordains or anything like that. Because, I mean, they know that I have Propaganda in my deck, so the extra card draw kills all the tokens, doesn't just kill. So having extra tokens doesn't really matter all that much. Hmm. Okay, I'm in. This looks like a Dig Through Time or a Treasure Cruise. So let's let Remora trigger in response, sack Scalding Tarn. And I think I'm mana draining the Treasure Cruise. The reason is, besides using 2 mana now, which I guess is nice, having 8 mana off the mana drain is a pretty big deal, especially since I'm, I guess I should have drawn my card first. next turn, potentially getting to play a bunch of cards. Alright, one draw step. Come on. At least hit some card draw to start chaining card draw. No. Yeah, I block Pyromancer and die, so yeah, I'm dead here. My opponent's not gonna fail to attack me. Alright, well that was unfortunate. Let's put in True Name and Vendilion for some Flusterstorms. And put in Mental Misstep. And what am I cutting for Mental Misstep here? I guess maybe I just put in the True Name and not the second Vendilion. Alright, I would in fact like to play first. And well, that sounds good. Alright, let's see if this deck can end up cashing. I would not. Again, I think this deck's a bit of a stretch. I don't know if I'm actually going to end up playing it, but it is not the best against Mentors and Pyromancers. Alright, I'm just going to start with a Time Walk here. Because if I draw a land, I can just play a True Name Nemesis. And that would be a pretty sweet turn one play. Alright, missed on land. Ooh. Let's just keep the land. I could keep Mental Misstep, but I don't know. Feels like drawing a land so I can just play a Jace is better, though I guess against Pyroblast I would rather have True Name, or rather have Mental Misstep. Alright. It's on double blue turn one, which is less good in that deck than it is in others. I wonder if I should repeal the Mox end of turn. If I repeal my opponent's Sapphire, they're not on double blue anymore. And I have more outs to play Jace, which I think I would rather resolve than a True Name right away, at least. Unless I draw land, I should be able to find something to pitch to Force of Will that is not True Name Nemesis, though I wouldn't mind doing that if I had to. Ooh. Mystic Remora. Kind of have all the options here. I think I just go with Jace, though. Reason not to play Remora is getting Mental Misstepped would be pretty unfortunate. And without my opponent having red mana, I'm a little less concerned about playing Jace. Alright. Let's hope my opponent does not have a Flusterstorm. They do. Alright. Well, that did not work out, but I still have a True Name Nemesis. Now, of course, I wish I had just played Remora, but especially my opponent pitched Dig, which indicates to me that they do not have Mental Misstep in hand. But they can't have very many other lands if they played Island on turn one. Or not. And maybe they did because they knew they just wanted to leave Flusterstorm up. Who knows? Looks like a Mentor to me. Yeah, there's a Mentor. Alright, time to get out of True Name Nemesis. Certainly can't wait. Choosing my opponent. True Nemesis has protection from Princess Power. Good to know. So Pyromancer, sure. True Name will hold things off for the time being, but yeah, I'm starting to lose now fairly badly. Turns out this deck's sweet, but then I just played against two Mentor decks and died to both. I was really close to going to game three of the last one. Not that I think that means I was super close to winning the match, but it would have been nice to find that back to basics earlier and actually get to lock my opponent out, as I was attempting to do. But here at two tokens per spell, and my hand having a lone solitary mana drain, means I think I am in a bit of trouble. Do we chain cantrips here? Who knows? Not yet, at least. Jace is a card. Alright. Cast Jace. At the very least, it will require my opponent losing some creatures to kill it. Draw some cards. Yeah, I guess I have to do it this way. Because I want True Name, and I want a blue card to pitch to Force of Will, so. So at the very least, my opponent's going to have to lose Young Pyromancer in order to kill Jace. Attack with Pyromancer, Monk, and Elemental. I get to block Pyromancer, then if my opponent has a spell, the Jace does die. Ancestral Recall. I guess I've got to force that. It would be pretty impressive if my opponent had assembled Ancestral plus Pyroblast, though. Yeah, so now you can sacrifice a Pyromancer to kill the Jace. Not a bad trade. I mean, you probably have to do that. Oh, wow, my opponent cast a Ponder and found Ancestral into Treasure Cruise. yeah, I'm real dead. Now the Monastery Mentor gets to attack. So now, opponent can actually kill Jace without losing anything because the Monk and the Mentor are both big enough. Alright, I've had enough. I think I'm going to go ahead and concede. This deck is sweet, but I would not recommend it.